Welcome back. February is Heart Health Month, and tonight we're talking to an Arizona man with an experimental pacemaker that could end up saving a lot of lives.
Team 12's William Pitts talked to the patient and the doctor about this tiny device keeping him alive.
I mean, I feel no difference, at least now.
Not bad for a guy who had a heart attack.
Feeling great. Yeah.
At least that's what Adam Boaz's doctors told him.
I remember getting ready for work that day, and that's about it. So.
And then waking up.
Waking up in the hospital, yeah.
He still doesn't know why. Adam was only 37 when it happened. Doctors say there's really nothing wrong with his heart, but it could happen again.
Not what you expect to ever wake up to, especially like just wake up in a hospital and be told that you know, cardiac arrest isn't.
Dr. Thomas Mattioni at Honor Health Research Institute had an idea for Adam, a combination defibrillator and pacemaker. There are two parts to this. There's the defibrillator, that's the big part. It's a smaller version of the big defibrillator they use in hospitals. Then there's the pacemaker, a little thing the size of a AAA battery that's placed inside the heart for smaller shocks.
It's a tiny little bullet-sized self-contained unit that has no wires.
The two talk to each other wirelessly and decide which shock Adam needs.
The novel part is this communication system between the two devices that really hasn't been done before.
And that was the catch. It's experimental. Adam was the first Arizona patient to ever get it.
A bit concerning to try something new, but if you have the opportunity to do something that could be helpful to people in the future, you should probably take that opportunity and do it.
But this was not just invented yesterday. We've been working on this for quite some time. And the system, I'm happy to say, is functioning perfectly so far.
The proof is in Adam, walking around a couple of weeks after surgery.
Kind of the reason why I continue to do clinical research.
Adam may have already been shocked, maybe more than once. The device is designed so he probably would never even know. What he does know is that he's still here.
Got a second chance, so yeah. I'm just trying to be the best person I can be.
William Pitts, 12 News.